Hello everyone, I am Dr. Vijay Lakshmi Dayal, Professor and Head at Maharaja Institute of Technology, Mysore. So here I am going to explain in engineering physics subject, which is designated by the code 18PHY 1222 as per VTO, and the first module which I am going to take it deals with oscillations and wave. So here we have to learn about the simple harmonic motion, damped harmonic motion and forced harmonic motion, and we will take certain applications of it. And in the next part of this module and briefly discuss about the shock waves. So coming to first part of the syllabus of module 1, the syllabus is briefed out here. We have to understand the free oscillation, definition and characteristics of simple harmonic motion, then derivation of simple harmonic motion, mechanical simple harmonic oscillator, that is mass suspended on a spring. We have to take the springs in series and parallel combination, and when we have to find out the spring constant. Next is complex notation and phasor representation of simple harmonic motion, free oscillation definition and equation for motion for free oscillation, and the natural frequency and time period of the free oscillation. In the other part, we'll understand what is damped and forced oscillation, theory of damped oscillation. Over cases of damped oscillation, we'll go for over critical and under damping condition, quality factor. Then we'll learn the theory of forced oscillation and resonance condition, sharpness of resonance, and lastly Helmholtz oscillator, and which is example of mechanical resonance. And after completing the theory, we'll solve the problem which is prescribed by Visvesvaraya Technological University, that is VTU, and then the next module will be covered by some other faculty. First, I will like to explain the basics of motion and oscillations. What are the types of motion? And you have already studied. But to understand this topic, I'll just brief it out the types of motion which we require to understand simple harmonic motion, and also briefly I'll discuss the cause of oscillation. So let us first understand with the basic of motion. So what we know that motion can be classified into two broad categories. First is translatory motion and the second one oscillatory motion. So as we know that translatory motion, it is defined as the motion in which the position of the particle varies linearly with time in a straight line. And you can find this type of motion in a train moving in a straight line, a ball rolling on the ground. But to understand the simple harmonic motion, we have to understand the two basic type of motion, that is periodic motion and the translatory motion. So what is periodic motion? A motion which repeats itself after a regular interval of time. For example, if we take a minute hand of a clock, then it repeats itself after every 60 minutes. If you take our hand of a clock, it will repeat its motion, means it will come to the same point after 12 hours. Second example, we can take the revolution of Earth. We know that Earth revolves around the sun and it comes to the same position after 365 days. So, coming to the oscillatory motion, the definition says that a body in a periodic motion executes to and fro motion about a fixed reference point, then it is said to have an oscillatory motion. Now, periodic motion, I have already explained what it is. It is a motion in which the body repeats its motion after a regular interval of time. Now, let us understand with an example what is oscillatory motion. So, if we consider a pendulum, pendulum is a system where a bob is hanged with a string about a fixed position. When it is brought to a fixed position and left free, then it oscillates about a fixed point, suppose what we call it is O, and this fixed point we call it as center of oscillation, or we call it as mean position, or the position of equilibrium. So, this bob oscillates to and fro about this fixed point, to and fro about this fixed point, and when it is left free, suppose from this point, from here, one complete oscillation will be when it comes back to the same position. In the case of pendulum, what we understand, the motion is periodic and as well as to and fro. But whereas when I have explained the example of minute hand, it won't reverse back its direction. So, here in the case of pendulum, what it is executing periodic as well as to and fro motion. So, this kind of motion we call it as oscillatory motion. The other example, you can take it a spring mass system means a mast attached with a spring and it is left to oscillate freely. If we understand O is a fixed position, then it will oscillate about this fixed position at a regular interval of time. So, we can understand that all kind of periodic motion, it is not oscillatory, but all kind of oscillatory motion, it is periodic in nature. So, to understand the cause of oscillation in a system, we have considered a spring mass system, means mass of M attached to a spring and it is free to oscillate on a surface. Now, to understand this, we have to understand first two terms, elasticity and inertia. What is elasticity? The property of a body by virtue of which it retains its original dimension when the external deforming force is removed. And inertia, as we have studied in Newton's first law of motion, what it says, the body will be in the state of rest or motion until and unless an external force is applied to change its state. Now, if we consider this spring mass system, which is oscillating about the mean position O. If this spring is stressed, due to the elastic nature of the spring, the restoring force sets on the spring and it acts in the direction opposite to the displacement. And in the case the spring is compressed, then the restoring force F, it will be in the right direction, means the positive direction. Here the restoring force, it is in the negative direction. So when the spring is stressed, due to the restoring force, the negative velocity is imparted to the body. And inertia in turn try to resist the motion. The restoring force, which acts on the body, tries to bring it to the mean position, and hence the negative velocity is imparted to the body. When the body reaches its original position, here the velocity, it is maximum. So it overshoots the mean position and move to the negative direction. If we take a coordinate system, this is a positive x direction and this is the negative x direction. So overshoots the equilibrium position, but inertia in turn try to resist the negative velocity, and hence after the displacement x in the opposite direction, for a moment the body comes to halt, but in that time the spring is compressed, and in the positive x direction the restoring force is set, which tries to bring the body to its mean position. And hence the positive velocity is imparted to this body, and try to come to the mean position, means the first position, and again the velocity is maximum at the origin, means the mean position. And later what it happens, due to this restoring force, the positive velocity which is imparted, the body overshoots the mean position and come to the second here, this stretched condition position. So this state of imparting the restoring force to the body, means due to the elastic nature of the spring, and inertia in turn try to resist any change in the state of motion, the positive and negative velocity is imparted due to the restoring force, and inertia in turn trying to resist the motion, the body oscillates, and at the end what is extreme end, the velocity will be equal to zero for a moment, but what is due to the restoring force, the velocity is imparted. It can be negative velocity, it can be positive velocity. So due to the elastic nature of the spring, or due to elastic nature of a system and inertia, the system continues to oscillate. And if any friction acts on the system, any kind of force acts on the system other than the restoring force, then it tries to stop the motion of the body, which we will understand in the case of damped oscillation. What it happens, the body first it oscillates with its maximum amplitude, and if another force acts, finally it will come to the halt. So let us start with the main part of the syllabus, which starts with simple harmonic motion. As already I have explained the types of motion and I have explained the cause of the oscillatory motion. Now we'll understand what is simple harmonic motion. So simple harmonic motion is a special type of motion in which the body oscillates such that its acceleration is always directed towards a certain fixed point and its magnitude is directly proportional to the displacement of the body from that point O, and the fixed point is called the center of oscillation. Let us understand with the help of a figure. So when a body oscillates, the restoring force sets in the body to bring it to the mean position, as already I have explained previously. So force, we know it is equal to mass into acceleration. So by the definition we understand that the acceleration of the body is always directed towards its mean position and its magnitude is proportional to the displacement. So we can say that acceleration A is proportional to the displacement, and here the minus sign, it suggests that the acceleration is directed in the direction opposite to the displacement of the body. So what are the characteristics of simple harmonic motion? First, the motion should be periodic. Second, a restoring force sets in the body which tries to bring it, means the body, to its mean position. So restoring force, as I have already explained, force is equal to mass into acceleration. So this, as the restoring force is sets in the body which tries to bring it to the mean position, we can say that the acceleration as well as the restoring force, acceleration as well as the restoring force is directed towards the mean position. Both, as the restoring force is directed towards the mean position, so the acceleration is also directed towards the mean position. And the next characteristics is what? The magnitude is directly proportional to the displacement. So if the displacement is in positive x direction, the restoring force or the acceleration sets in the negative direction. Both is in the direction opposite to the each other. So from the point 2 and point 3 we can say that acceleration, we can also say the restoring force, acceleration is directly proportional to the displacement of the body, and this negative sign here suggests that the direction of the acceleration or the restoring force is in the direction opposite to the displacement. So we can write it, acceleration is directly proportional to minus x, or we can write force, that is the restoring force, is directly proportional to the displacement. Restoring force is directly proportional to the displacement. And when you remove the proportionality sign, you can introduce a constant, that is k here. So we can write it, force is equal to minus kx, where k here, it is proportionality constant which we can call it as the case may be, force constant or the spring constant. We even call it as stiffness constant. As I said, what is the problem? Based on that, we have to define it as force constant, spring constant, and while calculating the nature of the spring, we call it as stiffness constant as well. So next, we'll derive the differential equation of simple harmonic motion as well as its solution, means we'll try to find out the equation for displacement. We'll consider a body of mass m which is undergoing a vertical displacement from here onwards. I have explained whatever the previous explanation, it was there, it was as per the horizontal displacement. Now we'll understand in terms of vertical displacement. So I have introduced the term here y. Now as explained, in the case of simple harmonic motion, the restoring force F is directly proportional to the displacement of the particle, and it is in the direction opposite to the displacement. So instead of x, what I will replace here with y. Restoring force is directly proportional to the displacement, but is in the direction opposite to the displacement of the particle, and this is nothing but the Hooke's law. Now if you remove the proportionality sign, you have to introduce a constant, as I have explained it, and this constant k we call it as force constant spring constant or the stiffness constant as the case may be. So let us say that this is equation 1. Now as per the Newton's second law, We understand that any type of force, it is product of mass and acceleration. So we can write F is equal to M into A. What we know, A is rate of change of velocity, means acceleration is rate of change of velocity with respect to time, and velocity is rate of change of displacement with respect to time. So this acceleration, we can write it as d2y by dt square. Again repeating, acceleration is rate of change of velocity with respect to time, and velocity is rate of change of displacement with respect to time, and hence this acceleration can be written as d2x, or the case may be here we are taking it as y, so d2y by dt square. Here we can replace it by d2y by dy by dt. Velocity, rate of change of displacement with respect to time. So the acceleration can be written as double differential of displacement with respect to time. Let us write it as equation number 2. Now equation 1 and 2 is the equation of force. So we can equate it and write M d2y by dt square is equal to minus ky. Both F in the left side, if it is equal, then the right side must also be equal. And equating equation 1 and 2, we get M d2y by dt square is equal to minus ky. Now let us take this term to the either side. We get M d2y by dt square plus ky is equal to 0. Now let us divide this equation. We will mention that this is equation 3. This equation 3 by M. So what we get? If you divide by M this equation, this part of the equation, then MM cancels out and you will get d2y by dt square, and this, when you divide it, this part of the equation, you will get k divided by M into y. And 0, if you divide by any value, you will get 0. So this we got by dividing equation 3 by M, that is the mass of the body. Now let us simplify this equation further and replace k by m by omega square. So we get d2y by dx dt square plus omega square y is equal to 0, where omega square is equal to k by m, or you can write omega is equal to square root of k by m. And omega we call it as angular frequency of oscillation. So this equation, I am naming it by equation 4, this equation 4 is known as differential equation for simple harmonic motion. Equation 4 is known as differential equation of simple harmonic motion. Now let us simplify this equation, means let us solve this equation to get y value, means the displacement value for the simple harmonic motion. So we have derived the differential equation of SHM. So as per the question what it is given, the question may be starting from the Hooke's law, derive the differential equation of SHM, or in continuation it can be asked starting from Hooke's law, derive the differential equation of SHM and find its solution. So we have to continue it further. So to derive the general solution for this differential equation, let us multiply the equation by dy by dt. So what we get multiplying by dy by dt, d2y by dt square into dy by dt plus omega square into dy by dt into y is equal to 0. Now what we have to do, we have to integrate this equation, and remember while integrating this equation, we'll integrate the higher order term. That is d2y by dt square and dy by dt. So integrating d2y by dt square, we get dy by dt. And when you multiply after the integration dy by dt, we can write it as dy by dt whole square plus omega square. Now integrate dy by dt, integration of dy by dt is y, and when you multiply by the y, you will get y square. And integration of 0 is c, where c is the constant of integration, Now let us find out the value of integration constant, and for that we'll take a condition. Condition is what? If the body displacement, we assume it is in vertical direction. So from the mean position, the maximum displacement is A in both the sides, means the amplitude of oscillation is A. The amplitude of oscillation from its mean position, it is A. The maximum amplitude is A. So y is, we will take the condition that at y is, when y is equal to A, that is the maximum amplitude, and We know at the extreme position, as previously I have explained during cause of oscillation, the velocity will be maximum at the center, and at the extreme it will be equal to 0. We will be equal to 0, and the velocity we define it as rate of change of displacement with respect to time. So dy by dt will be equal to 0. So when y is equal to a, dy by dt is equal to 0. Let us substitute in equation 5, dy by dt is equal to 0. So 0 square plus omega square, the value of y it is what? Is a. So a square, this will be equal to c. So this suggests that c is equal to omega square into a square. So substituting this value, c value, in equation 5, what we get? Dy by dt whole square plus omega square y square, and c is what? Omega square into a square. Now further we will solve this equation. Dy by dt whole square, this will be equal to omega square a square. Take this omega square into y square in the right hand side. What you get? Omega minus omega square into y square. So further solving the equation, what we get? Dy by dt whole square, that will be equal to omega square common, a square minus y square. And if you take square root in the both sides to remove the square, what you get? Square root of omega square is omega, and a square minus y square. So now let us rearrange this equation. Dy divided by square root of a square minus y square will be equal to omega into dt. Now again integrating this equation, let us write it as equation number 6. What we get? If you integrate it, integration of dy divided by square root of a square minus y square will be equal to sine inverse of y by a. And integrating dt, what do you get? Omega into t and constant of integration phi. So solving the above equation, we get y by a is equal to sine omega t plus phi, or y is equal to a sine omega t plus phi. So equation 7 represents the general solution for the differential equation
of simple harmonic motion.
So in today's session we have learned the types of motion which will require basically to understand the simple harmonic motion. We learned the cause of oscillation. We have learned about the simple harmonic motion, means definition of simple harmonic motion and its characteristics. We have derived the differential equation of motion using Hooke's law, and then we have derived the general solution for simple harmonic motion. Thank you.